Quiet leadership, winning hearts, minds, and matches is an autobiography which revolves around the managerial career of Carlo Ancelotti between the period 2001-2015. Carlo Ancelotti started his footballing career in 1974. During his career, he ended up being an integral part for his teams. He was a key part of the successful AC Milan squad from 1987 to 1992, then won a Serie A title, two European Cups, two European Super Cups, two Intercontinental Cups, and a Supercoppa Italia. Ancelotti's footballing career had to cut short due to his injuries. Hence, he retired in 1992 at the age of 33. Carlo Ancelotti started his managerial career with the Serie B side Reggina in 1995, after serving as the assistant manager for the Italian team between 1992 to 1995. Carlo Ancelotti left after only one season and went to Parma, where he brought success to the team. In 1999, Ancelotti was appointed as a manager of Juventus. Despite winning the Intertoto Cup in 1999, Ancelotti had a difficult tenure with the Bianconeri, as Juventus kept on suffering huge losses during his two seasons as manager. Ancelotti was eventually sacked in 2001. In November 2001, Carlo Ancelotti got a call from a familiar face, Adriano Galani, the CEO of AC Milan. In 2001, Ancelotti was appointed as the AC Milan manager after the sacking of the previous manager due to his poor results. Carlo Ancelotti was not able to change the 2001-2002 season much. Then came the 2002 summer transfer window, when AC Milan bought three main transfers, Nesta, Seedorf and Rivaldo. AC Milan also started their own lab for better training facilities. He also asked his midfielder Andrea Pirlo to play in a deeper position. The changes were evident, and AC Milan became title contenders. With this, AC Milan won the Champions League and the Coppa Italia in 2003. The next season, Rivaldo cancelled his contract and left for Olympiacos. With this, he signed a young star, Ricardo Kaká, and a World Cup winning captain, Cafu. As a result, AC Milan became a dominant team in Europe and won many titles, which includes another Champions League in 2007. By the time Carlo Ancelotti left AC Milan in 2009, he had left 8 titles for the Rossoneri. Ancelotti had a 2-year stint at both Chelsea and PSG from 2009 to 2013. He won 3 titles with Chelsea, which includes the Premier League and a Liga title with PSG. His next journey would find him at the greatest team in European history, Los Blancos, Real Madrid. In June 2013, Ancelotti became the manager of Real Madrid. Before Ancelotti's tenure in Madrid, Los Blancos were casted under the shadow of the greatest Barcelona team with the manager Pep Guardiola and a young Lionel Messi. Barcelona won everything that was there to win from 2008 to 2013. Ancelotti started working quickly to reshape the team. Madrid brought in Isco and Gareth Bale for a world record deal at the time. They also saw the departure of two key players, Gonzalo Higuain and Mesut Ozil. Real Madrid improved a lot under Ancelotti, with players like Ronaldo and Angel Di Maria excelling with his tactics. With this, Real Madrid won the Copa del Rey final against Barcelona in 2014 and reached the UEFA Champions League final after 12 years. Atletico Madrid struck first at the 36th minute. As the match went to the 90th minute, it seemed that Atletico would win the UCL, but the captain of Real Madrid, Sergio Ramos, had other plans. Real Madrid took the match to extra time and annihilated their opponent, winning 4-1. Real Madrid achieved La Decima, Cristiano Ronaldo achieved a new Champions League record, and Carlo Ancelotti accomplished a new record, the most titles in UEFA club competitions. In 2015, Carlo Ancelotti would find a new league, a new nation, a new stadium, a new journey, der FCB, FC Bayern Munich.